Dan Illman, Mike Beer, race number 7 at Saratoga not only kicks off the 50-cent late pick 5, but it is the most prestigious race for 3-year-old sprinters in the entire country. It's the Grade 1 H. Allen Jerkens at 7 furlongs, and you can bet it with a DRF Bets account. Sign up at drf.com/bet. Use that $100 in deposit match to play this 50-cent late pick 5 on Run Happy Travers Saturday. Let's meet the field for the H. Allen Jerkens. We've got a horse that's odds on the morning line, and why not? The number one Chancelot is a perfect 3 for 3, and he popped a 121. You heard that right, 121 buyer speed figure in winning the local prep, the Grade 2 Amsterdam. Drawn inside, he is on a run and gun mission.
Yeah, he's just really, really fast. I think the interesting thing about this race, outside of the fact that it's just going to be interesting to see what he does as a follow-up to the Amsterdam, is for a Grade 1 sprint, there's not a ton of speed in here. This is a wicked fast horse. You know, it may not be reasonable to expect him to run another 120, but it almost feels like he could regress 20 points and still beat this field.
That's a very good point. I mean, this is a horse that's run 100 buyer in his second lifetime start. And just taking a look at the past performance of the rest of the horses in this race, none of them have ever earned triple-digit buyers. Chancelot has 2 from 3 starts. It's scary if you believe even has a forward move in him. But let's look at the Timeform U.S. pace projector. They have Chancelot on the lead. The 2 Call Paul, who was not drubbed by Chancelot in the Amsterdam last time out, he returns after kind of a weird placing in the Grade 3 Quick Call. I wonder if Jason Service was using that race as a bridge to this, because he's always seemed more like a dirt horse. He's very honest. He's won half of his 10 lifetime starts. I just wonder if we've seen his best, and his best is a low to mid 90s buyer horse.
Yeah, that's how I looked at him too. I mean, you know, he has a nice record winning half of his starts, but it's, you know, all of his wins are when he's just a huge favorite against weaker competition. And then when they step him up into tougher races, it almost feels like he's just not quite that good. And I would also just, you know, look at that pace projector and think, how in the world is this horse keeping up with Chancelot early? I don't see that kind of speed from this horse.
I mean, the fact that the number 3, 12th Labor, is close to the pace shows you that there probably isn't a lot of gas in here. 12th Labor's cutting back from a one-turn mile, and he did a nice job in that race for Dallas Stewart. Dallas's horses often progress with maturity, and this was kind of fits the profile for races like the Allen Jerkens and the Woody Stevens. We like turnbacks going 7 furlongs. I just wonder if 12th Labor has it in him right now to take down Chancelot, because he has a lot of catching up to do on the buyer scale.
Yeah, he really does need to take a huge step forward. I do like him cutting back a furlong in this race, and he was very game, I thought, to win last time. But an effort like that probably isn't getting him much in this field.
Another horse cutting back in distance is Rowaiton, who had trouble in the Dwyer 2 starts back, down on the inside, kind of blocked most of the way. Don't think he would have beaten Travers Bound Code of Honor anyway with a clear run. They ran him in the Curlin over a wet track. I don't think he likes a wet track. He was prompting the pace, and it was a race that went to closers. He is another one. I like the cutback in distance. The question is, can he stay close enough, or will there be enough pace that he can come from way behind?
Yeah, I would think that, you know, Chancelot's just going to go fast early in this race, whether he has pressure or not. So I think the pace will be there for this horse. And I really like him cutting back. And just, I don't think he wanted any part of 9 furlongs last time. His Dwyer was good. His allowance when prior to that was also very good, although he got a perfect trip that day. This horse is interested in here if he goes off at a price.
Hog Creek Hustle illustrates my point. You want turnbacks at 7, but the Woody Stevens did have a very, very fast pace. He was one of the few horses that was able to buck the gold rail, probably because the pace was so fast. Corey Lannery swung him to the outside. He was full of run, cutting back from a one-turn mile in the Pat Day Mile. This time around, it'll be interesting to see if the favorite is softened up. If somehow he is, this is a legitimate price horse yet again.
Yeah, he is. I don't have any knocks on this horse. I think this is what he really wants to do. He did run well in the Woody Stevens. Yes, the race set up great for him, and he got the clean outside run that maybe some other horses did not get, but he still ran really well in there, and there's going to be a fast pace for him once again, I think.
Mind Control at 15-1 sounds very appealing when you look at his early season form. He was won the Hopeful over this course and distance as a 2-year-old. He won the Jerome. He was 2nd in the Gotham. He won the Bayshore. What has happened in his last two races? Because they haven't been very good. I know he didn't break well in the Woody Stevens, and if you want to just say, let's throw that out, fine. But isn't he supposed to win last time out at Laurel?
You know, he is. Yeah, I will just say his Woody Stevens, I felt like he had a lot of excuses for where he didn't break. He was, you know, three or four wide throughout on that track where he didn't want to be. He also got into a little trouble in the stretch. He wasn't winning, but he did get into a little bit of trouble there. Last time, that trip just didn't work out. And I'm not going to blame Trevor McCarthy for it, but he just could not find anywhere for this horse to run through the stretch. He's altering course all over the place, trying to find a seam, and he only got it very late. It was way too late. I think he ran a lot better than it looks last time. He's a big price in here. I think he's very underrated, and I'm using this horse.
Let's talk about a couple of horses that were whipped by Chancelot in the Amsterdam, beginning with the runner-up, Nitrous. Nitrous is a true late-running sprinter. He actually broke very well in the Amsterdam. He was completely out-sprinted. He was in behind horses briefly at the top of the stretch. I like the way he was trying in the lane. Yeah. He was really running hard. He was just no match for the winner. This is a solid horse if you give him some pace, but the lack of speed means he's got to work out a trip somehow.
Yeah, he's just going to need a clean run into this thing. We'll see if he can get it because he got it in the Woody Stevens. I really liked the ride that Ricardo Santana gave him in the Woody Stevens, where he was able to save ground for a lot of that trip before he got out to the clear and then just missed at the end. He had no chance last time. He'll be running late in this race. You know, he's a horse that you could use somewhere. I preferred some other closers in this race, but I'm not against this horse necessarily.
I thought the Big S ran okay at Keeneland three starts back. He was off about two lengths slow. He was climbing while green over that muddy track while taking kickback. Four wide on the turn, only beaten two lengths. They put blinkers on. It was just sharpened him up too much in the looking at Lucky, and he burned himself out on the lead. But in the Amsterdam, he might have been exposed just a bit.
Yeah, he probably was. I still like this horse. I think there's some potential for better down the road for him. I'm a little surprised they're pressing on into the H. Allen Jerkens, but I think he's a talented horse. I just feel like this is too tough right now.
Let's take a look at our top selections for the H. Allen Jerkens. Chancelot, obviously, the horse to beat. That's where you're going. Baracho was only beaten a length in the Woody Stevens. He also was off the rail at some point in that race. And then he came back as the only three-year-old in a field of older optional claimers at Saratoga on July the 21st. It was a very comfortable win for Baracho, who improved his buyer to a 95, a career best. And this is a horse that I don't think needs to come from 100 lengths out of it. If he can remain in range, he might at least have a crack at the favorite turning into the stretch.
Yeah, I also think he's a very interesting horse. I put him second. I just couldn't pick against Chancelot in here, but this is the other horse for me. I think he's really improved, especially in his last three races. That was a pretty solid win last time against some older horses. I really liked that performance from him.
So you're going 1-4. I'm going 4-1-9-5 in the Grade 1 Allen Jerkens, kicking off that late pick 5 at the Spa on Travers Saturday. Get down with a DRF Bets account and the $100 deposit match that comes along with it. Sign up is easy. DRF.com/bet. Approximate post time for the H. Allen Jerkens, 2:59 Eastern. Best of luck.